it's probably the most powerful weapon system known to man. This is what scares our enemies. Okay, the left, the socialists, the Marxists, the communists. This is what scares them.
Hey, all, I'm John Avlon, and this is Reality Check on the extremist beat. Now, if the forces of Christian nationalism, conspiracy theories, and extremism in the military could be distilled into one person, it might be Michael Flynn, retired general and former national security advisor to ex-President Trump, now remade into a field marshal in the culture wars. Flynn was once a respected military leader. Now he is regarded as an unhinged political operative who barnstorms the country on a revival tour where he combines the tenets of Trumpism and QAnon and Christian nationalism, calling Democrats communists and saying things like, there's no way he'll turn over a communist country to his children and grandchildren. Flynn is a fallen figure to many former colleagues in the military and government because of his embrace of extremism. But to his adherents, he is a celebrity, a Christian warrior with credentials. Flynn is the subject of a new documentary by Frontline on PBS. But the purpose of our conversation with its correspondent, Michelle Smith of the Associated Press, is not simply to explain the psychology that leads a general to embrace extremism, but to explore the unholy mix of Christian nationalism and conspiracy theories that are coalescing right now and fomenting talk of a violent fight in America's culture wars. Michelle, welcome to Reality Check. Tell people about this barnstorming tour that Michael Flynn is on, its appeals and its appeal to the people who come there.
So we documented Flynn on traveling the country. He's actually had more than 60 events since January 6th. His premier event is called the ReAwaken America Tour. It started in the spring of 2021. It's now had 16 stops. It's generally a couple days long. Oftentimes it's in a church, and it has dozens of speakers. Flynn is the headliner, but there are people like Roger Stone, Eric Trump. Sometimes Eric Trump will call Donald Trump from the stage. There are lots of anti-vaxxers, and it mixes religion and conspiracy theory and politics all together. I attended for 2 days one of these tours in Western New York, and at the culmination of one of the days, they invited people to be baptized at the end of the day. I spoke to many veterans at his events. And others who were never in the military, but see him as someone who has special knowledge, who understands, the deep state. He often spreads conspiracy theories that are almost so wacky, like you don't want to even repeat them because they're just really out there, and people believe him because of who he is and his time in the military.
I don't deny that we've had elections. I deny that we have fair elections.
In his video response to our reporting, Flynn took issue with the term election denier, saying it was part of a misinformation campaign against him.
They're going to try to bash us across the head and shoulders with every frame that they can put against us. And every form of dis and misinformation.
He said he knows a misinformation campaign when he sees one.
I also have a level of expertise in these types of efforts, okay? And I, because having served on battlefields at certain levels, we would have misinformation, disinformation, PSYOP campaigns going on to get audiences, to get the enemy to think one way, to get the friendlies to think one way.
Another aspect of this is that in these Christian spaces, as we have been told from people who study them, there is a high regard for members of the military. So someone like Flynn is more revered maybe even than a member of the clergy.
The cross was actually General Flynn's idea to do an outside place so they can have some services and stuff. There's no way to argue with General Flynn. I would say he's a genius with what he can do, with how he does it.
One person we spoke to said he's like a spiritual general. And, there's a lot of mixing of these ideas of military. One woman we saw at one event, she was wearing a T-shirt, Army of God. And he kind of brings all those things together into one package, Michael Flynn.
You've spent over a year covering Michael Flynn, preparing this documentary. And in recent months, we saw videotape of Michael Flynn's testimony to the January 6th committee become public.
Do you believe the violence on January 6th was justified morally?
Take the Fifth.
You believe the violence on January 6th was justified legally?
Fifth.
General Flynn, do you believe in the peaceful transition of power in the United States of America?
The Fifth.
We spoke with more than 125 people for this film, and that was a shocking moment to them, that a three-star general who was once the, you know, national security advisor to the president would plead the Fifth to a basic fundamental part of our democracy.
When a former general takes the Fifth on whether he believes in the peaceful transfer of power against the backdrop of January 6th and his involvement and his continued involvement with Proud Boys and Oath Keepers, it raises the specter of violent reactions to elections that their team, quote unquote, does not win.
The rhetoric you hear frequently is us versus them rhetoric.
We're inside the walls of the deep state, and there is evil, and there's corruption, and there's light and truth.
That kind of rhetoric, we have been told by many people who study these things, is very dangerous because it puts things in very dire terms. And if you feel that your country, there's an existential threat to your country from evil, then you're maybe willing to do anything to protect the country.
Michelle, thank you very much for joining us on Reality Check, and congratulations on this extraordinary documentary.
Thank you so much.